you can use Copilot Studio to create agents, or you can use kind of pro code tools like Visual Studio, et cetera. And so we really are working hard to make sure that you can choose whichever, right? Whichever tool really meets your needs and you want to use, you should be able to build agents. You probably, one of the biggest messages that we had from Build last week was really this multi-agent concept as well, which really kind of brings that together, right? That you're going to be able to blend agents, whether they're made in the low-code tools or in tools like Visual Studio together. So it really becomes a matter of preference and what you want to use to build it. So I really want to double click on that message. So the other thing that Seb did brilliantly was all roads lead to the toolkit. So it was like we planned these demos back to back. So I'm going to be showing you the toolkit today, but I've got like four slides that I just want to kind of set things up and explain a little bit really around what the Microsoft 365 Agents SDK is, which was recently announced as GA at Microsoft Build last week. And so let's just dive straight in. So one of the things that we find, especially working in our team in the SDK and just with customers, is that they want to be able to go and they come to us and they're, hey, Sarah, we already have and know what model we want to use. It's already been approved by our board or by our company. And, you know, we're used to working with this. It's the same thing with orchestrators. So typically teams already know like Semantic Kernel, for example, a really, really popular orchestrator. They're already familiar with it. They don't want to use another orchestrator. They don't want to learn another one. They don't want to get trained on another orchestrator. They want to host their own code. And they want to be able to pick it up and put it wherever they want. And they want to be able to deploy it to where their customers or their employees are, whether that's M365 Copilot, whether that's Teams, whether that's a custom app or a custom, just any kind of custom website or application within their business. And then they also want to connect it to their agents, as I said before. And so this is really what we're trying to directly address with the Microsoft 365 Agents SDK, because it allows our customers to really do exactly what I just described. And it allows them to be able to bring whatever AI they want, whatever orchestrator they want to work with that AI, and really whatever knowledge they require to ground the requests and to ground their experience for their users. It's an open source SDK worked on by Microsoft. It's available at aka.ms/agents in three languages, C#, JavaScript, and Python. That's our parent repo that you'll be going to at the AKA link. And you can then just go ahead and click whichever language of preference you want to go and use. Our samples are at the parent repo. And it allows, once you've chosen your ingredients, your AI, your orchestrator, and your model, you go ahead and wrap that up in really what we provide in the SDK, which is a lot of conversation management initially. So you've got state or memory, you've got storage options, auth. We've worked really hard on auth, especially around 1P auth with Microsoft clients like Copilot and Teams. And then the idea is that then you wrap that up, and then developers can go deploy that to any of the 15 plus channels that we support straight out of the box, like Microsoft 365 Copilot, Teams, Slack, or if none of those serve your needs, you can actually go and build your very own channel adapter yourself and go push it over to wherever you need your agent to surface. And so the idea is that you can have whatever AI services you require. And the key thing here is about the evolution of your agent. You're probably going to want to change out the model. You're probably going to want to change out the services you use. You may even want to change the orchestrator in time. And it's around having that flexible nature to go ahead and adapt and evolve, as well as supporting multi-agent patterns. We often get dispatcher broker as being one of our most popular patterns where our customers say, hey, we want kind of, you know, to surface all these other agents, kind of like SME agents. And we want to be able to surface that in M365 Copilot. Sure, like you can go ahead and do that. And again, because we're unopinionated in the AI that you want to bring or utilize with the SDK, it really makes it very flexible to go ahead and actually use multiple different models and to have multiple different agents in whatever really pattern that you're looking for. Dispatcher broker is a term that we use for describing where an agent you've got like a main agent, which will be typically your SDK agent, your agent's SDK agent. And then you would then go ahead and bring in other kind of SME agents that will be very specific. Now, those agents can actually also be Foundry agents. They can also be Copilot Studio agents. So you could, a team could have built some agents in Copilot Studio. You could actually connect with our Copilot Studio client that comes with the SDK and actually connect with one or more than one Copilot Studio agent as well. So you can really try to build and build these multi-agent patterns. We have samples at the aka.ms/agents, our repo, that use Semantic Kernel, Foundry, LangChain, OpenAI Agents SDK, really just to showcase the flexible nature of the SDK. And before I escape out and show you this in action, as Seb mentioned around the toolkit, this is all being really brought together with the toolkit, with the Microsoft 365 Agents toolkit. And it's being brought together in a few different ways. And if we look at it from the perspective of the lifecycle of a developer, of a customer, you're going to be from the get-go, which is where we're going to start today. When you hit File New, you've got a bunch of templates available in the toolkit, and we've gone straight out the gate with two core templates. We've got our traditional and familiar to some of you, our Echo agent or empty agent. And so this is really that empty container that you can then go bring, as I said, your AI orchestrator and your knowledge. And really, we provide all of that scaffolding for you just to get started, so you don't have to go and grab our sample yourself. Or you can actually start with the one I'm going to show you today, our weather agent, which is really it will prompt you to say, hey, which LLM do you want to use? And it'll actually go ahead and add in either OpenAI or your Foundry agent, all straight into your code. And you can be up and running testing locally in a matter of, we're probably going to do it in less than 60 seconds today, which is really amazing. And what I mean by that is you're going to see me connect my AI. You're going to see Semantic Kernel at work. And you're going to see me test locally in the Microsoft 365 Agents Playground, which is directly embedded into the Agents Toolkit. It's a local testing environment for your agents that you can go use just to see, is my agent working? I've just put all my ingredients together. Have I baked what cake I need to bake? Right? And really, that's one of the biggest things that we've found is that you want to be able to see, is everything working? And then as you go through that life cycle, you can then go ahead and actually change different debug targets. So you can go ahead and actually say, well, now I'm good. This is working locally. I want to actually now see it working on my actual end client. So you can actually just simply change the targets, Microsoft Teams, or you can change the target to Microsoft 365 Copilot, and you can actually start to actually see your agent working in those specific clients. And the toolkit does that. The toolkit scaffolds this all up so you don't have to go and manually import your manifest file, et cetera. This is what the toolkit's always been good at. This is what the toolkit's always been fantastic at, being able to really save the time of developers from having to do a lot of this manual overhead, setting up things like middleware that you have to do if you choose not to use the toolkit. And then the last leg of the journey, which is around then once you're good with it working in your client, you can then go ahead and deploy it, which is really just around pushing your code. And so let's kind of see this. I want to show this. So let's go and just start from my Visual Studio. So I'm going to create a new project. You're going to have Toolkit installed. And then you're going to search for agents. So if you search for agents in templates, you're going to see the Microsoft 365 agents here. You're going to click on that. And you're going to name all your stuff as you would. And then what you're going to get is you're going to get a selection of different templates. Now, this is what I mean by me and Seb planned all this all along. You have a bunch of different templates here. Some of these more declarative, some of them what we refer to as custom engine. And you've got also a few different Teams templates here as well. So really, this is what I was talking about when I was saying like all roads lead to Toolkit. It's a fantastic place to start. You've got loads of different templates depending on what you want to go build. So if I scroll down here, you're going to find our Echo bot here, or Echo agent or empty agent. There's a few different words for it. This is a simple implementation. This is hey, I know best. I want to bring my own stuff. I just want the scaffolding. You go click that and you'll have all of the SDK code that you need. You'll have the agent's playground as well. All of that stuff. Great. but let's just kind of do something a little bit better, which is really, I want to be able to add in my own AI services and I want to use Semantic Kernel. So I'm in C# today. Whereas, so we have for our C# implementation, we've got Semantic Kernel and we've got Foundry and OpenAI, which you'll see in a moment. For JavaScript, we're using LangChain and OpenAI Agents SDK for our samples. So if I click Weather Agent, you're going to get a few different prompts. So it's going to say, cool, which LLMs do you want to use? We've got our two options, as I said, and now it's asking me for a bunch of stuff that I'm going to go and paste in. I've got my endpoint and I've got my deployment name. Great. Hit create. I'm still in a 60-second window. We can go for 2 minutes. It's fine. Let me move my window over. Great. Awesome. I'm just going to hit start. What's going to happen is Agents Playground's going to open in just a moment. We're going to see our code open. And we just want to wait for our Agents Playground to load. Great. We're good. So now I can just talk. And now I can just talk to my agent. And just like that, like less than 60 seconds, I've got a testing interface that I'm using Semantic Kernel, I'm using my Foundry agent, and there's no reason why this agent cannot be an agent host on Copilot Studio, an agent wherever it is. And I can put breakpoints in, do some debugging, you know, whatever you need to do to be able to really be comfortable with what you want to do. And if you want to, as I said earlier, if Agents Playground's great for local, that's awesome. But what you're going to want to do, once you're happy with that, testing in your actual target channel is your next stage of integration testing. As you will know, clients like our channels, they all work in wonderful and amazing ways, and they all render things differently, and they all behave slightly differently. They're all independent clients at the end of the day, and so. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to then kind of level up your testing. And the Agents Toolkit makes this super easy with Teams and M365 Copilot. And providing you're authenticating, you're signed in, et cetera, you'll see M365 Copilot here as well. You can see Teams already. So if you was to click Teams, you will actually have the like Teams client open and you would actually be able to test in Teams. It's the same for M365 Copilot. This is really fantastic for testing, especially UI stuff like adaptive cards, which typically have different support patterns across different clients. And just generally, again, like I said, best practice for integration testing. And really, that's it. I don't want to really. There's no reason to complicate this anymore. We've tried to make this as simple as possible for you to start, test, actually see your agents working. What we're actually going to do is after today, Matt's going to come in and do some proper deep dive sessions, just showing you things like Auth, the Copilot Studio client, all of the real kind of extensions and deeper dive things in the SDK that we've really tried to build out so we can double click on what you've seen today beyond just the final new experience. So yeah, I'll check. I haven't got my Teams open. I'll open Teams and check any questions. But yeah, I hope that helps. And back over to Germany.